Yes, I'll make lasagna today. And we'll see. This is, we will need zucchini. We will need carrots. We will need tomato paste. We will need minced lamb. In fact, I needed ground beef, but yeah, I forgot to catch it, and nearer, closer was some of this meat, so I take this. We need some flour for the bechamel sauce, and we will need some cheese. And some basil for in the vegetable sauce. Well, and of course the lasagna sheets. I guess they're like just four of them, maybe less. Okay, first of all, wash your zucchini. And I washed it already. So, and then, well, if it is biological, you can leave the peel on it. If it's not biological, you should also, yeah, peel with it, sort of this. Cut this off. Cut that off. Then. So the smaller the zucchini, the tastier they are, and the bigger you just can use them for soup. But the taste is less than. So if it's going difficult with a knife, you can first do higher and then lower to the bottom. Well, again, as in some other videos of me, your fingers like this and cut in front of your nails. Well, I do that. In fact, that's not really professional, I guess, but if the knife is really sharp, it also goes through your nails. So just be careful and slice this in like 5 millimeter pieces. So here are my sliced zucchinis. Now we just need to peel these small carrots. I like small. You need to peel more, but small is like smaller slices. I think it's tastier. Peeled my carrots. Now, well, again, in fact, it's the same thing as with the zucchinis, only I want my carrots smaller. I want them 3 millimeters. First, cut off the outer part, and then I'll maybe can do two. They were small, so I can look. Also, hands like a sort of a claw. Hold your thumb back. knife. Well, for people who have still difficulty to hold the knife, in another video I told you wrist is like this, but I see my wrist is like this, and then the knife is straight. If you push too hard, you can do this a bit with your hand. So if you just slice soft, then you slice straight downwards. Maybe I can... slice next to your nail. If your knife is sharp, warning, it can also go through your nail. So hold them straight downwards. Slice. This. Professional cooks use a bigger knife and they put the point on the cutting board. And, well, my knife is not as sharp anymore. Do it like this. Okay. Well, I sliced my carrots. And now it's time to fry the meat, the carrots, and the zucchini. Let me check if the video is correct. I guess there's nothing to do about it now. I hope the video is in the correct position. I again forgot to check it. Well, I have some oil in the cooking pan, in the frying pan. We need to be spread it over the whole surface. And we need to wait till it is hot. So see you when I go, yeah, put this Mainz lamp into the frying pan. There we are, back with some warm oil. And now I need to cut this open. Hope my knife is sharp enough. This is quite unhandy. Yes. It's unhandy package. Ready. Yeah. Now I need to make this into small pieces. make it small. Because it needs to be in the sauce. So when it's already brown, you can make it smaller. And well, in fact, we also need some salt. I use Himalaya salt from the hills, and it's a bit pink. I don't know if you can see. Yeah, you can see it's a bit pink. This should be enough. A tiny bit too much for when you use only meat, but all of this, this green stuff, vegetable stuff, is also going in. And it's, yeah, oh, in fact, this portion is for two persons, so one half for to eat now and one half for to put in the freezer for another time, so I don't need to have to cook every day. Well, you see, how this works. Cut all the big parts down till they were really small. Lasagna sauce, vegetables and meat sauce will be good. Well, we also need some bechamel. So what we need for that is, you can also use butter, but yeah, I like to use oil for this. And yeah, it's not as precise, but if you want to measure it, use always more oil than flour. And I will use like something like this for me. I don't need much. It's just some, yeah, sort of a decoration sauce between the vegetables and the lasagna sheets. And then add flour. Oh my god, my spoon broke. I need another level. Add flour till it is consumed. Well, now you see there's still a lot of oil. So I can add one more spoon. This looks like it. I only want a bit more, so you need some more oil. Now I see this. I think I need a bit more. Bit more oil. 1 spoon more flour. Well, let's see how the meat is going. Still need to cut it down a tiny bit. Yes, you can add the carrots here. Well, this needs to cook a tiny bit before adding the water or milk or cream. You can also add cream. First, add the carrots because of they were the hardest green. This one, the zucchini are soft, so they gonna be added later because of they were faster fried. Well, I forgot to say at the beginning that I also have some leek in the freezer, and this leek will be added at the last moment. So fresh as possible. This I have another video, and hopefully it's this video is turned good. Yeah. So I can add that video afterwards. Look, now it looks a bit crumbly, and that means it's baked quite well. Now I need to add water. Also mix the carrots into the meat. Never on the come on the ground. Then I can add the lid in the frying pan. This is faster. And now I can add some water here. I learned a trick to make this smooth. To add water and wait till it is, it's hot already, so now you can mix it till it is, wait till it is cooking, till it is sizzling. It's already sizzling, then you can mix it. Go till there are no how do you call that? We'll translate it afterwards, but till it is smooth. Let me say it like this. Add some more. Wait till it is cooking. Mm-hmm. So the water is over the whole place. Man. It's still cold. Just mix this up again. Look, it is cooking. I'll show you a bit closer that this is cooking. You see it's cooking, and now you can mix it. You mix till it is smooth again. Smooth, strongly, like this. We'll get it smooth. It's not really the easiest sauce to make, but try and you'll get better at it. Now, I need some more water here. Again, wait till you see it it cooks. Faster this time. Yes. Well, again, mix till it is smooth. It's already more sauce-like. Look at this. Yeah. This is for a thick sauce. You can well, I don't know how you call them. I will make it one day. For some ingredients you need some thicker sauce, and then this is good, but for today I want it thinner. So add water till it is like how you want it. Oh, I didn't wait till it was cooking, but you see it's solving already. Look, for this one, I can add the zucchini. It's just, yeah. Oh. Well, this looks good. Right, we need to just... It was on half on the heat, by the way. Why didn't I say that? Mm. Yeah, this should be enough. A tiny bit, it should have been a tiny bit more. So maybe I guess some spoons of oil and six spoons of flour will be better for two persons. This is more like, yeah. I need to do two times for a tray like 20 tray like this. Or is it an oven dish? About the oven, well, I need to put this oven on 180 degrees Celsius. I'll be back if this is quite finished. Yeah. Add the herbs and the tomato. I guess it was tomato, but this woman said tomato paste. Yeah. It should be tomato. I'm used to say tomato in English. We understand each other. Put the lid on this. See you. Okay. I also need to add some salt in the bechamel. Bechamel is for me. It sounds nearly the same. This should be enough. Mix it. Well, we need to add some of this. Wow. Made it dirty. Wait. The last bit needs to be like this. Add this whole package, about 100 grams. Also add some basil. Okay, and mix. Yeah, mix it. So now finishing of the lasagna. These are square and this dish is round. So I need to break it a little bit. And a few lasagna leaves. Maybe I can just do it like this. Poop choo choo. Yeah, then I need three. Maybe I can use three, maybe two. Yeah. Add sauce. Add some of this white sauce. It's maybe not enough. Hopefully it's enough. Oh man, I didn't add too much water. Well, okay, add some cheese. I'm in a hurry, the video is nearly at the end. And I cannot make longer than 33 minutes. So this should be good. Add one lasagna. And then repeat the process. Okay, after two layers of lasagna, three layers of vegetable sauce with meat, and yeah, I didn't have enough for the lasagna, the white sauce. So there's just two layers of this white sauce inside the lasagna, and I will show you if it's finished. Well, hello, this is the end result. And it's very tasty with cucumber with mayonnaise. And rest me to say thanks for watching and have a tasty meal.